Hello, good morning everyone. Today let us deal with the current affairs of various newspapers, Hindu, Live Mint and Economic Times of 8th December. Let us start with the first news. It says UN Secretary General invoked Article 99 on humanitarian crisis in Gaza. As we know that Israel-Palestine issue is going on since a long time. So Israel is attacking the southern Gaza. There is humanitarian crisis is going on in Gaza. As per the official report, death toll is 16,000. So UN Secretary General, his name is Antony Guterres. He invoked the Article 99 of UN Charter. Means he is urging the UNSC to please act on this humanitarian crisis in Gaza. Because Israel, as a part of eliminating Hamas, in the areas of southern Gaza, it killed half of Hamas battalion commanders, as per Israel official reports. And Israel is also attacking on normal people, hospitals and children. Okay, Article 99 of the UN Charter, Secretary General may bring to the attention of Security Council matter which it, in his opinion, may threaten the maintenance of international peace and security. So he has, the UN Secretary General has the special power to act on the emerging situation of international concern. Okay, UNSC is the most powerful body, but it still not adopted any resolution on a ceasefire between Gaza and Israel. So So Secretary General invoked this Article 99 by his showing, his asking the UNSC to please try to bring a ceasefire, stop this humanitarian crisis. Okay, it is very important, Article 99. Hatti community announces protests on December 16. So it is very important, the communities, Hatti community, it belongs to the state of Himachal Pradesh. They came to protest on 16 December. So why they are protesting? They are protesting, please implement the law which is giving us the status of scheduled tribe community. So they got the scheduled tribe status, but they are asking, please implement this. Okay. It is in UPSC prelims, they mostly ask the questions regarding communities, Hatti communities from Himachal Pradesh. The Constitution Scheduled Tribes Order Amendment Act 2023 granted ST status to Hatti community of Himachal Pradesh. But they are not implementing, state government is not implementing, so they are protesting. Okay. Next, center announces ₹1500 crore aid to Tamil Nadu and AP after cyclone wreaks havoc. We know that cyclone Michaung has hit the coastal areas of Andhra Pradesh and Chennai. So it is causing most destruction in Chennai and Andhra Pradesh. So to deal with this disaster, center is released 493 crores to Andhra Pradesh and 450 crores to Tamil Nadu. Okay, and they also, our Prime Minister has approved one project, that is first urban flood mitigation project. Urban flood mitigation project of cost 561 crores for integrated urban flood management activities in Chennai basin under National Disaster Management Fund. So under this National Disaster Management Fund, they are providing ₹500 crores. Okay. And Ministry of Home Affairs has provided the State Disaster Fund, State Disaster Response Fund, 493 crores and 450 crores. Okay. No consensus on setting up a judicial service government. Okay, there is no consensus in the government regarding the creation of All India Judicial Services, say Law Minister Arjun Ram Meghawal. Okay, it is important article from polity point of view. We have Article 312, which provides the Rajya Sabha a special power to create All India Services. Okay, they can create new All India Services by passing a resolution by 2/3 majority. So there is a demand to set up All India Judicial Services since a long time, but there is no consensus among the government regarding the creation of this All India Judicial Services. Okay, from prelims point of view, Article 312 is very important. Okay, let us move to the next news. Okay, UGC not soon for short term courses. Okay, higher educational, we have adopted the new education policy 2020. New education policy 2020. As per this, we are focusing on the vocational education. Okay, as per this, they are providing, higher educational institutes will provide credit linked skill development certificate courses. Okay, credit linked skill development courses for 3 to 6 months. Okay, skill development courses for 3 to 6 months for the people who completed their plus two, means inter, for the students who completed 10 plus 2, the government introducing some skill development courses. Okay, this was approved by UGC. What is UGC? University Grants Commission. Okay, they are included 29 courses and they have in this they can select any stream. In this 12 credits to 30 credits will be provided and they will get a diploma, means who the people who pursue this skill development courses, they will get one diploma certificate. Okay, they will have the exposure to industry setting or workshop and the joint certificates. These higher educational institutions will give joint certificates. Okay, it is a good step to promote vocational education to increase the employability. Let us move on to the next news. Okay, ADB. The finance package secured by Pakistan from ADB is $658 million. Okay, ADB, Asian Development Bank. Its headquarters is in Philippines. Okay, its quarter is in Philippines. It provided completely $300 million for improving resource mobilization to Pakistan. We know Pakistan is facing severe financial crisis. $275 million for schools damaged by floods and $80 million for agriculture productivity. In UPSC 1, they ask difference between ADB and Asian Infrastructure Bank. So let us discuss some more points about ADB. In ADB, the Asian Development Bank headquarters is in Philippines. The vote share is based on the capital they provide. Vote share is based on the capital. So, highest voting share is for China. And in ADB, we have other countries which are not in Asia. For example, in ADB, we have US also, Japan also. Okay, India has the vote share of 6.5%. Okay, we will tend to confuse that there is no US in this, but US is also there in ADB. This is one time prelim question in UPSC. Okay, this is one of the serious issues. 6% of cough syrup samples fail export quality test. Who is saying this? Central Drug Standard Control Organization. Central Drug Standard Control Organization is saying that 6% of cough syrup from 54 Indian manufacturers are failing to meet the mandatory quality test. Okay, CDSCO, Central Drug Standard Control Organization, is a regulatory body. CDSCO is the regulatory body for pharmaceuticals and medical devices. Okay, na? And we know that India has 20% share in global generic medicines. Okay, in global generic medicine, we have 20% share. India is known as the pharmacy of the world. ओके वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग हंड्रेड्स ऑफ कंट्रीज विथ वैक्सीन्स. We know that one means serious news. It is very sad news for India that children of Gambia, Uzbekistan, Cameroon, African countries died after taking the one cough syrup that was manufactured by Indian company. So WHO issued red flags. WHO issued red flags means you should not use India's drug syrups. Okay, why the children who consumed the this cough syrup in Gambia, Uzbekistan died means there is a presence of contaminated with glycol and ethane glycol, a toxic substance that sometimes fatal, especially for children. Okay, and we knew that the central government itself admitted that WHO issued an alert for Ganifen syrup. Okay, this Ganifen syrup that is manufactured by a Indian company, WHO issued a red alert, means you should not use this syrup. So we have to change this, we have to improve the quality standards, because these medicines have an impact on the life of the people. Okay, CDSO regulates pharmaceutical companies under Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940. Okay, CDSCO regulates under Drugs and Cosmetics Act 1940. Indian pharmaceutical sector. If we see the about Indian pharmaceutical sector, it contributes 1.72% to the GDP and 50 billion, with more than half of coming from the export. We are meeting the 20% global demand of generic medicines, so it is very important for India to improve its quality standards so that it not threaten the life of the people. So we have one news regarding Mahua Moitra. There are allegations on her that she is asking questions in Lok Sabha by taking cash. So ethics committee inquired on issue and it ordered the expulsion of this Trinamool Congress member Mahua Moitra. Okay, still the committee report has to be discussed in parliament. Center directs sugar mills distilleries not to use cane juice syrup to make ethanol. Okay, Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution directed sugar mills and distilleries not to use sugarcane juice or syrup to produce ethanol in the year 2023-24. Okay, it said with immediate effect. Okay, supply of ethanol from existing offers received by oil marketing companies. Presently, we are meeting the ethanol from B heavy molasses. Okay, Department of Food and Public Distribution. Who monitors this sugarcane availability? Department of Food and Public Distribution system monitors production, sale and stock of sugar in India to ensure sufficient availability for local consumption at stable prices. Why the government moved this means it we have to ensure the adequate availability of sugar for consumption. Okay, now first we have to meet consumption needs, then we can think of using sugarcane for this ethanol. We have other sources to make ethanol, such as we can make using this molasses. Okay, this move come under the sugarcane control order. Who issued this? Department of Public Food and Public Distribution System, which monitor the stock of sugarcane. Okay, we are trying to make 20% ethanol with petrol by 25-26. Okay, ethanol is produced from We have the target to 20% ethanol blending by 25 and 26. Ethanol is produced from sugarcane juice and molasses, but central government is asking, Department of Food and Public Distribution System is asking, please don't use sugarcane for ethanol now. We have to use it for consumption purpose. IDFC First Bank introduced UPI based digital credit card. Okay, it is important from economy point of view. IDFC, it is the first bank which issued digital RuPay card for its customers. Okay, and it seamlessly blends the benefits of UPI transactions with core credit. Okay, through this it will be easy to conduct transactions. You have to remember IDFC, and it made UPI based digital credit card. With this, let us end today's news. Thank you.